Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll be showing you how to connect to a PostgreSQL Server database from your Power BI desktop. So I have opened up my PostgreSQL Server database inside the pgadmin4, which is a tool that enables you to interact with PostgreSQL. So you need some information from here before you can connect to it from your Power BI desktop. You need to know the name of the server or the host name. You can see here on that connection, the host name here says localhost. Localhost is the same thing as 127.0.0.1. And then the database I want to connect to, I'm just going to expand this database, is going to be a database called DVD Rental. So let's go over to our Power BI desktop and make the connection. I have opened up my Power BI desktop and I've saved a new report. I've saved it as connecting to PostgreSQL Server. So if you haven't got it saved, it will show untitled. So anytime you want to save what you're doing, always good to save the file first and then save the changes as you go along. So let's go ahead and make the connection to the PostgreSQL. So I click on Get Data and I click on More. We wait for it to bring up more data sources. So I'll click on Database and I'll click on PostgreSQL Database. I'll click Connect. Now it's come up with this message saying PostgreSQL Database, this connector requires one or more additional components to be installed. So we need to go here where it says learn more, click on that link. So it takes you to this page and the connector we want is this connector here, npgsql. So what we need to do is download this .msi file. So click on it to download it. And you may get this prompt here, some security warning here. So I'm just going to click run. And it's going to try and run it. So it's doing a security scan. So you may get this option here. If you're on a Windows, it says Windows protected. Just click on more information and click on run anyway so that it can run the installation files. So that's it there. That's the installation file. Click next and click to accept. Click next and just click on this drop down here and select the middle one. Entire features will be installed. Make sure you've got that selected, the middle, and then click next and click install. And we'll give it a few minutes to do the installation. Once the connector has been installed, you will get the finish button highlighted. Just click finish. Now, for that to take effect, you will need to restart your computer. So I'm going to stop this video here. Restart my computer and we'll see you in part 2. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.